Hello. A few videos ago, we turned a 1980s daughter clock from a train station into a radio clock. A daughter clock doesn't have its own internal timing mechanism or power source. It relies on a mother clock for the timing pulse that advances the time. To get our train station clock working, we needed to emulate a mother clock, so we persuaded a Raspberry Pi Pico to act as one. The Pico listened to the radio signal from an atomic clock and provided a regular electrical pulse to the daughter clock. People wanted more details so that they could restore a clock themselves, so here it is, a few more details on how things fit together and also a link to the code that we used. To keep things vaguely interesting, we've done another quick clock restoration from start to finish. This clock was made by a German company called TNN about 70 years ago. The closer that you look at this type of clock, the more simple and elegant they become. A single coil of wire is doing the work. The coil of wire creates a magnetic field when current runs through it. There are permanent magnets inside the adjustment dial that are positioned with the opposing poles aimed at the electromagnet. By reversing the direction of the current through the coil's magnetic polarity flips, the permanent magnets are repelled, and the adjustment dials turn. People often take these clocks and remove the innards and replace them with a cheap quartz mechanism. Emulating a mother clock is better. It's less invasive and preserves all the nice original components of the clock. As an added bonus, it provides a more accurate time, as well as giving you the option of connecting multiple perfectly synchronized clocks to the Pico. Here's the building process. The first step, we clean the clock and give it a fresh coat of paint. Next, we assemble the components. A Raspberry Pi Pico, an antenna to pick up the radio signal, an H-bridge to supply the pulse that the secondary clock needs, a real-time clock as backup for the radio signal, and a step-up transformer to supply the clock's required voltage. The Pico connects to the real-time clock. We attach the antenna and the H-bridge to the Pico pins. We'll be using GP13, 14, 16, and 3.3 volt out. The Pico connects to the step-up transformer, which converts 3.3 volts to 24 volts. We only need milliamps of current to advance the clock, so this will be fine. The 24 volts go into the H-bridge, the connections go into the terminals of the clock. And that's done. When we connect the Pico to power, it listens for a long-wave radio signal from an atomic clock. As soon as that signal gives a valid time, the Pico updates its own real-time clock accordingly, and then starts producing the timing pulses for any connected daughter clocks. That's pretty much everything. Between this video and the instructions on our GitHub page, you should have no trouble restoring a clock, or clocks, of your own. Here it is in action. One slight issue is that you might end up with a gallery wall full of vintage clocks.